Hello and welcome to the TI Precision Lab Supplement for op-amp bandwidth. This lab will walk through detailed calculations, SPICE simulations, and real-world measurements that greatly help to reinforce the concepts established in the op-amp bandwidth video series. The detailed calculation portion of this lab can be done by hand, but calculation tools such as MathCAD or Excel can help greatly. The simulation exercises can be performed in any SPICE simulator, since TI provides generic SPICE models of the op-amps used in this lab. However, the simulations are most conveniently done in TINA TI, which is a free SPICE simulator available from the Texas Instruments website. TINA simulation schematics are embedded in the presentation. Finally, the real-world measurements are made using a printed circuit board, or PCB, provided by Texas Instruments. If you have access to standard lab equipment, you can make the necessary measurements with any Bode plotter and plus or minus 15 volt power supply. However, we highly recommend the Virtual Bench from National Instruments. The Virtual Bench is an all-in-one test equipment solution which connects to a computer over USB or Wi-Fi and provides power supply rails, analog signal generator and oscilloscope channels, and a 5.5-digit multimeter for convenient and accurate measurements. This lab is optimized for use with the Virtual Bench. First, calculate the closed-loop bandwidth and DC signal gain for the circuit shown here using the techniques and equations given in the bandwidth lecture. Use the datasheet parameters given on the next slide. This circuit uses the OPA171. In order to perform the calculations, you need to know the gain bandwidth product for that device. That value is given here. Enter your answers in the table in the middle of the slide. The solutions are already provided to allow you to check your work. Also complete the AC transfer function for this circuit. Again, the solution is already provided. The next step is to run a SPICE simulation analysis for the AC transfer characteristic. This will allow us to see the op-amp's closed-loop bandwidth and DC gain in this configuration. The necessary TINA TI simulation schematic is embedded in this slide set. Simply double-click the icon to open it. To run the analysis, click Analysis, then AC Analysis, then AC Transfer Characteristic. Run the analysis from 10 Hz to 10 MHz. You should see a result similar to this. Enable the cursor, then check the DC gain, or gain at minimum frequency. The result will be 26 dB, or 20 volts per volt. Next, find the minus 3 dB point, are the frequency where gain drops to 23 dB. This occurs at 159 kHz. Make sure to disable the DC power supply before setting up the test PCB. In the Virtual Bench software, click the power button in the DC power supply area to turn off the power. Check the front panel of the Virtual Bench unit to make sure the LEDs are off. Also make sure that the function generator is off. To prepare the test board for the measurement, install the jumpers and devices on circuit 2 as shown here. Install JMP6, JMP7, and JMP8, as well as the OPA171 in socket U2. This slide shows the schematic for circuit 2 on the TI Precision Labs test board. You will use this circuit to measure the bandwidth of the OPA171. For this measurement, only circuit 2 is used. Do not install any jumpers or devices in any other circuits on the PCB. Remove any jumpers or devices from the unused circuits and store them in the storage area at the bottom of the test board. This gives the connection diagram between the TI Precision Labs test board and the National Instruments Virtual Bench. Connect the provided power cable to the DC power supply of the Virtual Bench and power connector J4 on the test board. Connect VN2 on the test board to Virtual Bench channel FGEN, our function generator. Then connect VN1 on the test board to Virtual Bench oscilloscope channel 1, and VOUT1 on the test board to Virtual Bench oscilloscope channel 2. This lab requires additional Bode Analyzer software. Install the software, then run it by clicking Start, All Programs, Bode Analyzer, Bode Analyzer. In the configuration panel, set the power supply to plus or minus 15 volts, 0.1 amps. Press the green button to turn on the power. Set the start frequency to 10 Hz and the end frequency to 10 MHz. Set the number of points to average to 10 and the number of points per decade to 20. Press start to run the Bode analyzer. You should see a result similar to this. Enable the cursor, then drag the cursor, which is the blue dot, to the minus 3 dB point, or 23 dB in this case. Take note of the frequency. In this case, the result is 159 kHz, although your results may vary slightly. Compare the bandwidth measurement of the virtual bench to the simulated results from Tina TI. Also compare these to your calculated results. You should see very good correlation between all three values, although your numbers may vary slightly. That concludes this lab. Thank you for your time.